Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common Hyundai 1.6 gamma engine problems. Starting off with a little bit of background information and details about the Hyundai 1.6 liter inline four gamma engine. It's been in production since 2006 and remains in production to the present day as of 2023. So it's a very long running engine that's been around for a while and has been through a number of updates, changes, and different variants of the engine. One main difference, there are two main portions of the gamma engine family. And that is the Gamma 1 engine, which includes three variants, and then the Gamma 2 engine, which includes four different variants, and those variants include the MPI or multi-port injection, the flex fuel version, the GDI or gasoline direct injected version, as well as a turbo GDI variant of the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma 2 engine. Quite a few variants, just wanted to point that out and preface that video with the fact that there are quite a few variants of the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma, and since it has been around for so long, not all of these issues we run through and discuss will affect all years and models. So as we move throughout the video and a few of the most common Hyundai 1.6 liter gamma engine problems, I'll be sure to specify issues that affect certain engines or variants or years more than others. Jumping right into the most common Hyundai 1.6 engine problems, at number one, we have carbon buildup. This does only affect the GDI, the gasoline direct injected variants, including the turbocharged engine. So those two variants are prone to carbon buildup because with direct injection, fuel is sprayed directly into the cylinders. That is different from port injection, which sprays fuel into the intake ports and valves. So with direct injection, there is no fuel wiping off any deposits on the intake valves and intake ports, which leads to carbon buildup. And part of the way that occurs is all engines produce some natural degree of oil blow-by, which makes its way back into the intake tract. That then sticks to the back of intake valves and on the walls of the intake ports and eventually hardens and forms carbon deposits and carbon buildup. Over time, what that can do is it starts restricting airflow into the cylinders, which can lead to power loss, misfires, rough idle, and a number of other drivability issues. However, fortunately with the Hyundai 1.6 gamma engine with the gasoline direct injection, these engines are pretty good. They do have good PCV systems and they're pretty good at limiting the amount of carbon buildup. So this isn't nearly as big of an issue as it is on some cars, especially a lot of 10 or 15 year old German cars when direct injection was really just getting started and starting to blow up a lot more. Engines nowadays, including the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma 2 engine with gasoline direct injection, are much better at handling the oil blow-by and minimizing the amount of carbon buildup. However, the fact of the matter remains, without any fuel and detergents in that fuel spraying through the intake ports and valves, there is going to be at least some degree of carbon buildup on those valves and ports. We would recommend cleaning them roughly every 100 to 120,000 miles via walnut blasting. It's not absolutely required since carbon buildup won't cause any longevity or real reliability concerns. Again, just a few of the potential drivability issues if it's left for too long. So ultimately, if you want the Hyundai 1.6 GDI engine to be performing at its best, then cleaning those intake valves via manually cleaning them or walnut blasting them is going to be the best bet just to ensure it is running in optimal condition. That's really all there is to say about carbon buildup. Again, it only affects GDI engines and it's really not too bad on these Hyundai 1.6 liter gamma engines, so a fairly minor issue in the grand scheme of things. Moving on to common issue number two with the Hyundai 1.6 gamma, we have oil leaks. This is a pretty generic issue that affects a lot of different engines and cars. Gaskets, seals, O-rings are generally made of rubber or rubber-like material. And over time, with age, mileage, and that wear and tear, all of the heat cycles, Those gasket seals and O-rings tend to start hardening, cracking, and then developing oil leaks. So there really aren't any major design flaws with the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engine that do lead to oil leaks. However, there is one thing, we'll circle back to that in just a moment. But really, these are just due to age and mileage. Again, issues that pretty much any car and any engine is prone to, so nothing to really hold against the Hyundai 1.6 liter inline four engine. One of the most common oil leaks with the 1.6 liter Gamma engine is the valve cover gasket, and that's just a rubber-like gasket that is subject to a lot of heat cycles and a lot of wear and tear over the years. So especially on some of those older Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engines, since they are now 10, 15 plus years old, oil leaks are certainly fair game and do tend to occur occasionally, and the valve cover gasket is really the number one oil leak and something to be on the lookout for on the Hyundai 1.6 liter engine. Now, one other oil leak worth mentioning is just on the turbo engine variant of the Gamma 2. That is an issue with the turbo oil feed line. This part is known to leak fairly frequently, especially as the turbo 1.6 Gamma gets a little bit older. That oil feed line is known to go bad and begin leaking. Fortunately, it doesn't require replacement of the entire turbocharger, just the oil feed line itself. I believe it's a roughly $50 to $75 part. Fairly easy if you're a capable DIYer. Otherwise, if you end up at a repair shop, it'll probably be roughly a $300 fix to get that turbo oil feed line repaired. So that's maybe the one minor design flaw or defect that causes an oil leak on the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma. Otherwise, oil leaks are just part of owning an older car and engine. So if you are looking at a 1.6 liter Hyundai or Kia engine that is on the older side, 8 to 10 plus years, then oil leaks are certainly fair game. Moving on to common problem number three, we have the purge control valve or solenoid. It is part of the EVAP system, EVAP meaning evaporative emission system. This purge control valve or solenoid is electronically controlled. So over time, it does occasionally fail for electrical reasons. Fortunately, this is also a very minor issue in the grand scheme. The valve is very cheap, very easy to fix. And again, since it is electronically controlled, it's typically pretty easy to identify an issue with the purge control solenoid. You will usually get an engine code P0441. So if you have a code reader, plug it in and get P0441, then that is likely the EVAP system and specifically this purge control valve that is bad. Super simple, easy fix. A couple other symptoms just worth mentioning if you do run into this or you think you might be having issues with the purge control valve. You might have difficulty starting the engine and a rough idle once the engine fires up. And that is because fuel vapor is allowed to enter the combustion chambers when the valve or solenoid is bad. So effectively, you have too much fuel vapor in the engine, which is what can make it difficult to start the engine. And then once it does fire up, you'll have a little bit of a rough idle for a few moments until all of that clears up, and then you'll be good to go. One of the more common issues with the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engine, but really nothing to hold against it since it is such a cheap and easy fix and something that you shouldn't really be too concerned about if you do run into that issue. Last but not least on the list for the most common Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engine problems, we have catalytic converter failure. The catalytic converter on the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engine isn't a super common issue, certainly the least common one of the issues that we are discussing on this list of problems. However, it is worth the mention since catalytic converters are fairly expensive, and if it does fail, you'll be left with a pretty big repair bill, mostly just because the part itself is expensive. So there are two main ways that the catalytic converter fails on the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engine. And that is either it becomes clogged or eventually the catalytic converter becomes burnt out. Either way, it will require replacement because without the catalytic converter functioning properly, you will be unlikely to pass any form of emissions testing with a faulty catalytic converter. Again, this is one of the less common problems on the Hyundai 1.6 liter engine. So nothing to be too concerned about. And it does seem to affect the Kia Soul more than other models. And specifically, I believe around 2014 and 2015 are the most problematic. So if you are looking at a Kia Soul, it's something to consider, or any other car with the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engine. Any of the catalytic converters can fail. Fairly uncommon issue, just worth the mention, because if you do run into problems, it can be a fairly costly repair bill to get that fixed and replaced. Ultimately, that wraps up our foremost common problems for the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma engine. We would give this engine above average remarks for reliability. Carbon buildup only affects the GDI variants, and it's just the nature of owning a gasoline direct injected engine. They're all prone to at least some degree of carbon buildup. Installing an oil catch can can help reduce the amount of carbon buildup, as well as using various intake sprays and cleaners can help. But ultimately, still would recommend walnut blasting it or cleaning those valves roughly every 120,000 miles. But fairly minor issue. Otherwise, oil leaks. There is the turbo oil feed line on the turbocharged variant of the Gamma engine. However, otherwise, oil leaks are really just an age, wear and tear related item, and something that all cars and engines are prone to as they get a little bit older, so nothing to hold against the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma there at all. Then we talked about the Purge control solenoid, which again is a super cheap and easy fix, so not a big problem. Then the catalytic converters, which can be expensive, but are fairly uncommon on the Hyundai 1.6 engine. So nothing to really hold against the Hyundai 1.6 Gamma, and that is why we believe it earns above average remarks for reliability. That said, that wraps up our video for today. If you guys appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.